Last couple of weeks were crazy about AI hardware companies. First, Marques Brownlee reviewed Humane AI pin, and then Rabbit R1 handheld device, and rightfully he roasted both of them. And the thing is, both of these devices are actually quite expensive for what they are doing. It's because of all the hype. And actually, you can create a device like that or mobile application like that using your phone at home by yourself. And I want to show you how is that possible and give a glimpse of it and see what we can do. Discover how easy it is to do, actually. Firstly, last August, I announced I gave a break to YouTube for a short while and wanted to focus my attention on a side project I am developing, which I call Neocortex. And I spent most of my free time and weekends on it, and it came to certain place right now. And since everybody started talking about AI hardware and AI tools, I thought it was a good time to give you a sneak peek about that. So just before recording this video, literally I spent almost 1 hour, wrote 70 lines of code, and on top of that using Neocortex web platform and Unity SDK, and I made a small Unity application. And what it can do is that I'm gonna show you, and let's give it a try. So I made this very basic looking, pretty much there is nothing on it, some audio, feedback, and a button to start. Let's get it focusing. This is all. And I'm gonna start the listen button and start talking to it, and let's see what it does. Hey, what is the capital city of Estonia?
City of Estonia is Tallinn.
All right. So can you call Harrison for me? Oh, so the number shows up. I don't make the call directly, so just opening the dial on. And let's go back. And this is the one I like the most. I have a banana here, and I'm gonna ask what this object is. So can you tell me what this object is?
Taking a look. This seems to be a banana, probably a couple of days old.
All right. So it is the coolest thing is this is not a fake it till you make it application. It
does assist you.
Oh, all right. Just let's turn this off. This is not a fake it till you make it application. It does really work. Neocortex has audio support, chat text support, and image recognition and visual support as well. So when you connect things together in a very simple way, because SDK has all the support, it just works. And it is all possible by the SDK and Neocortex web platform. At the moment, you can help me greatly by following Neocortex X account and LinkedIn account. I will share them in description. And on top of that, I'm trying to conduct a user research. I'm trying to talk to as many of you as possible to understand what kind of pain points you have, especially if you are working in tech companies and trying to utilize these kind of technologies, or you have ideas about using these in your games or virtual assistants or smart gadgets. I can try to help, and I would like to talk to you and understand what kind of needs you have and understand which one of them I can actually bring to Neocortex and make it a full product that way. So feel free to reach out to me. I have my email in YouTube. Also, you can write to me through Twitter or LinkedIn. I'm really looking forward to your messages. So thank you so much for listening. It is really exciting, and I'm looking forward to sharing more with you and share this source code of this demo project as well, so you can build on top of that. Have a nice evening. Bye-bye.